What's good YouTube? I'm back with another video, and today, as you guys can see from the title, I am going to be doing kind of like a challenge video. Before I start, remember to subscribe if you're not subscribed already by hitting that notification bell so you can be notified every time I post up a video. So let's give this video a huge thumbs up. I would gladly appreciate it. Go check out all my other videos I have been posting lately. Love all the support that you guys have been giving me. I say this every single time, but it's true. I love you guys so much, and I would not be doing these videos if it wasn't for you guys. So without further ado, let's get right to this video. I have like 9 questions, I think. Not 9 questions, but 9. Okay, the name of this video, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be, it's my first time tag, basically. So basically, when was my first time doing these things that I have here on this list? I wrote down a few down, and then I'm gonna write my answer on this whiteboard, and then I'll show you guys right here after I finish writing it. So let's just get right into it. The first question was my first kiss. When was my first kiss? My first time getting a kiss. Lila, I'm breaking out. Don't mind my hair either. Let me see. I want to make sure I'm writing this right. Okay, so my first kiss, I might, for a lot of you guys, probably this is old already, but I was very focused in school. But a lot of people actually got their first kiss even past this. So, when 9th grade, 14 years old, so my freshman year of high school is when I got my first kiss. I didn't have no boyfriend or nothing in middle school. Like, there's people that have, but I have not. So 9th grade, 14 years old was when I got my first kiss. I think you guys can see it backwards here. Okay. Next, my first time being sent to the principal's office. Ooh, it could be the good or bad. I'm not saying it's just bad or whatever, but my first time getting sent to the principal's office was, okay, I have a story for this one. Wow, I misspelled. I'm so dumb. Wow, that looks terrible. Let me see if I could do it. Oh heck no, that was just terrible. Yeah, no, I don't know. 12th grade was my first time being sent to the principal's office, but it was for a good reason. I mean, at first, when this is what happened, I was in my counselor's office, my college counselor, well, not college, but she would be the one college advisor in high school, dealing with like colleges we got accepted to and whatever during our senior year of high school. So I was in there, and then one of the assistant principals come to the office, and mind you, it was me, a lot of my other friends, and she comes in and she was like, "Oh, you have to go to the principal's office." Yeah. And what's crazy is that everybody was just looking at me like, "What?" Because the thing is that I'm actually, not to like brag or anything, but I'm an actual good student, and I was never sent to no principal's office. I was never like in trouble in school, never got into fights, nothing. So out of nowhere, the assistant principal comes into the room and says, "Vanessa, you have to go to the principal's office." She knew my name and everything. So I was just like, okay. And then everybody was just staring at me like, what? Like, confused, because we all was thinking like it in a bad way, that they needed me to go to the principal's office. So I'm like, okay. So I go, and I'm nervous because I'm just like, I don't know what to expect, I don't know what's gonna happen. I was just like, oh my god, I'm about to get in trouble for what? Like, I was literally starting to think of things like, why would I get in trouble, why this, why that? But to find out, when I went over there, if you guys haven't been part of my channel for a while, I did explain when I first started my my first time going to Europe, and it dealt with, I was in high school. It was a school study abroad type of trip, but it was for like a week and a half. And so that assistant principal was going with us, and they wanted me to go because the thing was that my passport, because obviously they needed like a copy of our passports and whatever. Not that it had expired, because it wasn't expired, but they needed one that had more months. Like, I only had 3 more months until my passport expired, and they needed at least 6 months. So they needed to send me as soon as possible, because the trip was like, I think like a week. Yeah, a week later. And so she was like, they were like, oh, you need to go as soon as possible. So they actually paid for me to get my passport renewed to get it the same day. So I did that the day before of the trip, I think it was. It was 12 hours. I had to go to Pennsylvania. I went with my mom and then one of the deans or anything from my school, and we took the principal's car. It was so crazy. And the principal's nephew came also. And we went to Pennsylvania, got that, because the place that does it here in New York was booked and they could not accept like no more. So we had to go to PA in order for everybody else to go on the trip, which I felt was messed up, because if I wasn't able to go, oh well. But I guess, you know, whatever. So that was my first time going to a principal's office, and I was getting scared for no goddamn reason. My next one is my first video. Now, this, I'm not gonna write it here because I don't know the specific date, but it was in October of 2017. Nope, 2016. October 2016, I already had a YouTube channel. I just never uploaded videos because I was not interested in that. I just had the channel to like, because you have to have an account to like videos or comment in videos or whatever. So, and then my first video was October 2016, which I posted up a video of me and my boyfriend. I created like a little collage, an iMovie for my boyfriend, because I think it was like our anniversary or something, or I just wanted to create it and post it up there. Nothing for like fame or anything. It was just to post it up there. My first pet. Now, actually, I'd never had a dog, never had a cat, nothing like that. And I actually at one point thought that I didn't have any animals, but then I remembered when I was in when I was younger, like I could say when I was young to like when I was like maybe like 5 to when I was maybe 10, 11, around there, I don't remember the age. We had 2 parrots, but they were like small parrots, like very small. And we would have them like up like in the kitchen area. And I remember we had 2 of them, but I don't know what happened to them. I think either my mom had let them go or whatever, because I guess she didn't want them anymore or something. I don't remember. Oh no, we gave them to my aunt, I think, that also lives in New York. I believe that's what I think happened, and we gave it to them. Now, I don't know what they did with it, but yeah, I think that's what happened. But my first pet was parrots, which is different, but that's my first and only pet that I've gotten. Next is, what was my first job? Oh, I'm shaking this table like there's no tomorrow. My first job would be, you guys are not gonna be able to read that, but working at a gift shop in a museum. I forgot to put that. In a museum, it was my first job working in the Jewish Museum in Battery Park. If you guys are tourists in New York, you guys know that Battery Park is close to where the World Trade Center was at. Also where you go take the ferry to go to the Statue of Liberty or Ellis Island. So I worked at the museum there as a job, as when I was getting paid. Now, if it was like an internship, That's something different because my first internship was working at like a actors fund. Actors Fund was like a company in Times Square, and well, 47 like Rockefeller Center. And I was an intern there for like 2 weeks because I was doing something during the summer and stuff. And then my actual first job where I started receiving money was in a museum, in a gift shop, the Jewish Museum. Next, my first cell phone. Now, a lot of people have had like the Razor or Sidekicks or whatever, but my first phone was, if I'm not mistaken, was like a Android, like a Samsung Android, but it was very small. It was burgundy and black, I remember. I got it when I was in eighth grade. I remember in my eighth grade year, I also had surgery, and like a month or two later, my father bought me a phone, and I got that Samsung. Like I said, it was small, it was burgundy and black. My first time going on a plane, now I don't remember my age, but I do remember, I was really young. That's all I remember because I was maybe, let me see. My first trip, I know I went to the Dominican Republic was my first trip, but how old I was, I think I was around maybe, oh no, hold on, my sister was born. So I was around, I think I was like around 6 or 7 years old when it was my first trip. 6 to 7 years old, and I went to the Dominican Republic with my sister. Then the second time, it was around my 9th birthday because I celebrated my 9th birthday over there in the Dominican Republic. And then by that time, my brother was already born and my sister. So, yep, I was like 5 or 6 years old when I went to the Dominican Republic. First person I texted today, I'm gonna write this right now. My boyfriend, XOXO. Mwah. Yep, it was my boyfriend who I texted first today. I always text him first. I always text him good morning. I mean, he used to do that to me, like text him first, well, text me first, but he don't do that anymore. But it's okay. But I text him first because my family's here. Then usually, like my father would text me, and then I'll text him. But besides that, my boyfriend is the first and the only person I text in the morning. And my last, oh wow, this is my last one already. My last one is my first tweet on Twitter. My first tweet that I've done. Now, I honestly had to backtrack and go on my Twitter and check this out because I honestly did not remember. Because I realized I had 446 tweets on Twitter. And actually, my first thing on Twitter that I did was I actually retweeted something, which I didn't like post anything or whatever. It was just a retweet of, I forgot what it was, but it must have been funny, or a quote. I like retweeting quotes and stuff. But an actual tweet that I wrote, my first tweet was in January 23rd of 2017, and that I wrote this, and I quote, "I hope everyone has a blessed day today with prayer hands." And that was my first tweet on Twitter. So I hope you guys enjoyed my first time tag. I convinced all of you guys to do it. It's so much fun. If you guys want me to do a part 2 with other first times, let me know in the comment box down below and give this video a huge thumbs up. I would gladly appreciate it. So yeah, without further ado, remember to subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Hit that notification bell so you can be notified every time I post up a video, as well as give this video a huge thumbs up. Would gladly appreciate it. And remember, Nessa loves you guys from the bottom of my heart, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. I am out. Bye.